迎收看旁观华尔街视角。华尔街当然是跟股市息息相通，我们今天讨论一下怎么样在这个时候进场买股。那么很多投资人都认为应该是趁低入场。我们知道现在股价比较低的，受创伤最大的就是那些直接受疫情危害的，比如说是赌场、邮轮、航空类股等等。那当然疫情过去之后，好，这些行业一定会复苏，因为人们一定会返回到这些行业来进行消费。那现在是不是最好的进场机会呢？最近这两天已经有游人返回赌场了。那么就这些问题，我访问了 Lerrea 咨询公司总裁 Aquiles 先生，他是这么回答的。
I'm not a gambling man, but if I were a gambling man, I would say this.You go in knowing full well with your eyes open that it could be problematic at first. I mean, yeah, you could watch another 8 to 12% on the downside, but not that much more. I mean, depends on the company, depends on, you know, people are going to want to start traveling again in the areas that are less affected. So, you know, people are going to start taking vacation. Those are the areas that once the turnaround starts, the move on the upside is going to continue moving up for quite some time, and we should see anywhere, you know, not only recovery to where its base was, but also anywhere between a 10 to 12% once things have finally stabilized in that sector. But it could take years. So I'm not betting the farm on that. I wouldn't go more into that area.More than 5-6% at this point. I'm just not convinced it's over for them just yet.
好，如果说我们不趁低入场追低，我们来追高，也就是说现在有很多大型科技股，像亚马逊啊、苹果啊等等这些股已经升势非常好了，但是是不是他们还会有进一步上升空间？现在进场是不是有点晚了呢？
You know, for 20 plus years, I've been hearing, is it too high? Is the price too high? And then all of a sudden it goes up another 1,000%. You know, it's just one of those things. It's one of these companies, you know, the leaders in their area, the high flyers in their sectors destroy the competition by continually innovating. And when you innovate, you are miles ahead of your competition.And Apple is one of those companies that, you know, the consensus with analysts and people across the street, you know, you ask anybody's opinion, say they are the leaders in their sector until the competitor that is equally as strong comes along. Same thing with Amazon. You know, they're a big leader in their area. Someone comes along that's big who can topple them down, then it's going to be a different story. Or if the fundamental changes, if the fundamental where they are no longerbe it the leader orthey don't have the concurrent technology necessary, you know, until that time, those stocks are going to continue rising. Maybe albeit not meteorically, but maybe we'll see, you know,2,000, 3,000 in a very short period of time. And if you own these stocks, they are going to reward you for owning them. We also have to watch who are their competitors and who of those competitors is poised to be the next Apple. Because you know what? I want to get in on those companies too. So there's no reason not to. We just got to do our investigations and hopefully...We all win because those sectors just seem to be doing very well right now.
上次你点击的几只股啊，这好像最近表现都不错。那我们今天是不是再跟进一下？首先是那个 Teladoc 这家公司现在表现怎么样？
是的 ，Teladoc 最近表现也不错。那像我上次提到的呢，它在今年呢是出现了流量上的一个大的爆发。今年前三个月呢 ,Teladoc 它的线上问诊已经达到了200万。这个数字在美国已经是比较惊人的了。那同比呢也是增长了一倍。然后 Teladoc 呢它今年在线上的这个注册的医师已经有50,000人，现在可能已经超过这个数字了。那这个 base 还是比较庞大的，所以呢也给它形成了一定的护城河。那它的股价呢我们也看到在今年1月份的时候还是80多美元，但现在已经接近200美元了。 那我认为之后呢，美国或者是整个美洲地区也会出现这样的形式，就是现在 Teladoc 它是一路的领先，那之后比如说 ZocDoc 还有其他也可能是新的这种 startup 也可能直接 IPO、去跟它抢占这个市场份额。那最近看到比较有意思的一个这个观点呢，就是很多人拿 Zoom 和 Teladoc 来做一个比较，因为这两家公司在今年的股价的增长还有这整体的特性上面还是有点相似的。那我认为呢Teladoc 它在估值方面是更有优势，因为我们经常用的一个 ratio 就是这个 price to sales，就是它的这个估值，现在的市值对比它现在的营收这样一个比值，那 Zoom 呢已经是非常高了，它是已经超过80，现在在85左右，但是 Teladoc 呢它仅在20几，所以从这个估值角度来看 Teladoc 还是有很大的增长的空间。今年全年的营收呢，照去年同比达到100%增长，这个问题应该是不大的。
还有一只股很早以前我们也聊过，叫 Roku， 那这个公司现在的状况如何呢？
是 Roku 呢，它在这个3月份大跌超过一半之后呢，很快的在5月初的时候又回到了之前的一个价位，但是6月份又一直比较低迷，从可能130多美元跌到了100几这样，那最近的这一周这5天之内吧，又涨起来了，现在大概是增长22%，就本周的一个涨势，那这个最近呢，大家还是有一些正面的消息，比如说对它的这个长期的趋势呢还是比较看好。那之前呢这个6月份比较低迷，5、6月份比较低迷是因为这个大家认为它1、2季度广告营收受到很大的冲击，和 Google 这种大型的巨头呢在广告方面也是受到疫情的冲击非常严重，所以呢 Roku 它作为一家成长型的公司，它这个受到打击呢是很正常，所以呢在股价上面也直接体现出来了这个折扣，就是大家的担忧情绪。但是从这2周开始，一个是这个 Roku 呢，它在大数据和精准营销方面也开始发力，比如说它跟这个 Kroger， 这个大型的这个超市，他们呢是有一个这个做 data science 的很强的一个团队，叫这个Kroger Precision Marketing 这样一个 program， 那跟他一起去合作呢，一定会在未来的这个广告增长方面，奠定一个比较不错的这个科技的基础。
谢谢您的收看，我们下次再见。